So we're talking a lot about where liquid water can be, mm-hmm. right? But do we know that we need liquid water for life to exist?
That is a very good point. So I would say, according to physics, we don't. We don't mm-hmm. necessarily need water. But water certainly has its own function mm-hmm. To support life.
Well, we know water works.
Yes. Well, even say, like, we are not talking about water. We're just talking about, like, in general, liquid medium,
yeah.
right? So we need such a liquid medium to first dissolve chemicals so they can engage.
They can swim around and they can find each other to do chemistry.
Exactly. Right. And then we also need such liquid medium to transport chemicals to different parts, right? Mm-hmm. And then this chemical medium is ideally also a reactant. Mm-hmm. So, for example, water is one of the reactants in, like, the photosynthesis processes. Mm-hmm. So, well, according to those criteria, we probably have, like, other options. For example, like ethane or ammonia or ethanol, things mm-hmm. like that. But water has its, you know, has its own advantage. So first is that it has a really high boiling point compared to all the other options. Mm-hmm. So at 100 Celsius, it's turning into vapor, which means under 100 Celsius, which is already, you know, fairly high, mm-hmm. It would remain liquid. So of course we want the temperature range for which the liquid medium could remain liquid as large as possible, right? Mm-hmm. So that it has the largest possibility to find it liquid at a given point.
But the fascinating thing is, like, I mean, you mentioned hydrocarbons. Doesn't Titan have hydrocarbon rain?
Yes.
So, like, it almost every substance then designates a new habitable zone where it is liquid. So, like, something as cold as Titan, now you just have a different compound that offers a liquid medium. Mm-hmm. That's just crazy to think about. If you get rid of this water-centric view, then you have all these substances and all these regions where you could have liquid something.
That's true. Mm-hmm. But one thing to keep in mind is even in the world life developed on Titan, well, just because it's such a cold world, then the metabolism rate would be extremely low.
Right. It's so difficult to do chemistry.
It's difficult. And it's also difficult to develop intelligent life mm-hmm. just because our brain is very energy consuming.
Mm-hmm. That's true. Okay.
Yeah.
So energy, or I guess maybe the leveling factor is, it doesn't matter what the liquid medium is, but there has to be chemistry occurring. There has to be an exchange of materials and bonds breaking and bonds forming.
Exactly. Tying to which, water has another advantage, which is it's a polar molecule, mm-hmm. which means it could dissolve other polar molecules, for example, the salt, right? But it wouldn't dissolve the, say, the cell membrane. Mm-hmm. So that is something really important. So, for example, all the hydrocarbons you were talking about, I believe those are mostly nonpolar. Mm-hmm. So the cell membranes that are found in typical organisms, that would completely just dissolve in such.
But maybe some other region has discovered a different kind of cell membrane whereby the outer edges are the nonpolar and the polar is the middle section, or so, you know.
Yeah.
Could be totally different. But I think that the temperature thing stands still. No matter what substances you're using, there has to be enough heat energy for reactions to happen.
Exactly. And the last point is for water, once it freezes, ice would float on water. So that prevents further freezing of the liquid media.
Right. That's a fun little coincidence there too.
Yeah.
It's fun to think of all these little coincidences that worked out, you know, the moon and then the, you know, magnetic field, and then just the sheer probability that ice is less dense as a solid, you know, all this random stuff. But I do like the point that you made about water being polar, and that there can be minerals dissolved mm-hmm. in there, right? Because when we think about abiogenesis, I mean, we don't really fully understand how it happened on Earth. But I think my favorite hypothesis is this thing about the tidal pools. So you've got these tidal pools, right? The tide comes in and out. So you have these extended periods of time where there's just a little pool on the beach. And because of all the rock and stuff, there's different minerals. And then, I mean, I studied a little bit of, heterogeneous catalysis. You've got some mineral surface, you've got some metal atoms or something, and then you've got whatever you have, and you've got an amino acid or something, mm-hmm. and it just sort of makes its way to the mineral, and then something polymerizes, we don't know for sure, but it sort of works there, that polymers could form in these little tidal pools,
Yeah, exactly.